Hi, it's time for healers. I mean, you read the title, you know what this is about. We're gonna be looking at what do you need to do to be a good healer in Mythic Plus and in raids, and then rate the healers. When it comes to Mythic Plus, we want damage, we want good utility, we want good single target cooldowns for your tank and acceptable AoE cooldowns for your group. It is also important to have some modicum of defensives for yourself and not be too squishy and helpless when you go into higher and higher keys. When it comes to raids, we want big raid cooldowns. We want damage reduction cooldowns, strong single target cooldowns. Mobility is more important in raids than it is in Mythic Plus, as well as high throughput raid-wide AoE healing in a raid environment. Uncapped heals, not requiring being stacked, are also going to be very powerful in raids compared to Mythic Plus. So, let's go. So we start first with Holy Priest, because I wanted to start from the bottom in all categories, so yay. Holy Priest looks like an obsolete version of a healer. It looks like it came from 10 years ago. WoW has evolved in this time and Holy Priest has remained there. WoW now is about burst, is about damage reduction cooldowns, strong raid cooldowns, utility and damage in Mythic Plus as a healer. All things that Holy Priest has lost or never gotten in the first place. Holy Priest has basically the weakest probability of all healers. Desperate Prayer and Guardian Spirit on himself are terrible as a survival tool, which hurts them in both activities, Mythic Plus and raids. Their damage is the worst of all healers, tied with Mistweaver. They are terrible, even with new things, all combined, Smite, Holy Fire, Shadow War Pain, Shadow War Death, they are terrible. There is no talent or legendary synergizing and allowing you to do more damage. They even lost Mindseer in the process. It's just a sad situation when it comes to damage. It hurts them too much, particularly Mythic Plus. They do gain the benefit of having Must Dispel for bursting. Their strongest tool has always been very strong, consistent, solid throughput HPS. They don't need cooldowns, they don't need to line up multiple things to have consistent HPS, which helps them doing Prideful, the new affix. They are among the better specs to deal with Prideful due to the pulsating stacking damage that it does. And admittedly, thanks to the Must Dispel of bursting and the Grievous spot healing for single target required to deal with high Grievous stacks eating away at your party, Priest is also okay when it comes to that. But between the very little DPS, the terrible utility, they have Mindsuit now, which can help for skips, they can talent into a knockback and talent into a stun, but it's just not enough to be considered having good utility as a healer. Their legendaries don't help them. Harmonious Apparatus is basically a summarization of what Holy Priest is, which is consistent and stable HPS. You wanted something more out of your legendary. Divine Image, if it worked, it could be very strong. Right now, half the time it's broken. And the rest of their CDs are tragic. Holy Priest also has among the worst combined CDs as a healer. Divine Hymn and Symbol of Hope are a joke. In Mythic Plus, they are almost a waste of a cooldown, and in raids, they are facilitators for other healers. You are the cuck helping the Chad healers actually do something. And Guardian Spirit is another facilitator. Beyond the cheat death, which can be bypassed by heavy damage a lot of times, it's just a 60% healing increase on the target. A lot of the times you want to use a strong single target cooldown to give yourself breathing room as a healer. Time to do something else. Lots of times in Mythic Plus is time to heal the rest of the group. Guardian Spirit only tells you that you're gonna have to heal the target to gain any benefit, which is not what you want from a very strong single target cooldown. And all of these things just hurt Holy Priest too much in both activities. When it comes to raids, they are in E tier due to their lack of strong cooldowns, their terrible survivability for themselves, and not a very heavy scaling with gear that is expected from them. They're not one of the specs that goes into overdrive with more gear. And when it comes to Mythic Plus, good news, they go from E tier to D tier. They are promoted by one tier, but they're still the worst. No damage, very little utility, terrible survivability in high keys, bad cooldowns for the tank and bad cooldowns for the group. It's just a mess right now. Now we move over, but not that far away, because we move to Discipline Priest. Discipline Priest, unlike its shitty brother, actually does have DPS, does do a lot of damage, to the point that it has already been nerfed in the alpha and beta multiple times. Recently, Shadow War Pain and Shadow War Death nerfed, and the Shadow War Death legendary Kiss of Death also nerfed. But their damage is very strong, which is already good for Mythic Plus, as it is part of their core healing rotation. Discipline Priest is amongst the harder to play healing specs. They do require a lining up of multiple cooldowns to be effective. Power of Solace, Schism, Penance, Mind Blast, they all have to be set up together to heal. You don't just carpet bomb the entire raid with Rejuvenation and then you're done. You actually do have to have a little bit of finesse. They do retain the same weaknesses of Holy Priest when it comes to very bad utility, bad survivability, albeit stronger because Pain Suppression is a much stronger cooldown. Your legendaries are also mediocre, not because they were bad on their own, but because they have been nerfed multiple times, specifically Kiss of Death and Cauterizing Shadows. Your really strong point as a priest are your cooldowns. Pain Suppression for single target, Barrier for AoE are already amongst the two strongest external cooldowns a healer can have. And then you even have Rapture, which is an amazing cooldown because of its versatility. You can use it to spam it on a single target, you can use it to cover your entire party in Mythic Plus, you can use it to cover just two targets. It's just very, very versatile, which makes it very, very strong. And as I mentioned, throughput, high throughput, is much less important nowadays. Burst windows are more key, and the entire healing rotation of a priest revolves around burst windows, as I mentioned, with all of those cooldowns that they have to line up. They set up their schism and then they do their entire extra spell power window of damage converted into healing through their atonement is very, very powerful. And this works really well in Mythic Plus, and it works still well in raids, albeit a little bit worse due to their necessity to spread their atonement to way more targets than they have to in Mythic Plus. Their real big problem when it comes to Mythic Plus is their single target healing. Similar to Holy Paladin, they don't want to break their damage rotation to be healing with Shadowmen. Similar to how Holy Paladin doesn't want to break their damage rotation to heal with Flash of Light or Holy Light. They sort of miss that, which can be a problem in Mythic Plus. Because in Mythic Plus, outside of their Pain Suppression, when their tank drops to 30% HP, yeah, Discipline Priest has problems. They have to start using Rapture just to spam on one target, maybe even Barrier just to use it for one target, so it's a little bit more complicated. It might become worse as we scale deeper into the expansion and we go into higher keys, but for now, Discipline Priest remains an S tier when it comes to raids. Their cooldowns are just too strong. Their entire base of damage prevention and shields and absorbs is just way too strong in raids. And then for Mythic Plus, they are in A tier. They do lack the utility for Mythic Plus, but they do have the damage, they do have the cooldowns, so I think they will be a pretty decent, pretty solid pick for Mythic Plus, particularly with self-sufficient tanks, which allow them to do their damage rotation without having to break it to use Shadowmen, specifically things like Blood Decay, for example. And up next, we have Resto Druid. So Resto Druid has remained in the stereotypical position you imagined it from BFA. Resto Druid is the king of Mythic Plus, and below average, or actually average, in raids. Druid remains the strongest class in Mythic Plus when it comes to utility. It's not just the amount of utility that you have, like for example a shaman being able to rival a druid in number of utility abilities. The real key is the uniqueness of those utility abilities, the fact that no other specs or few other specs can bring the same things you do. For example, Cyclone, Mass Entanglement, Typhoon, Ursal Vortex. These are very unique and specific things that only Druid has, or only Druid and maybe one other spec has. And this doesn't even include having a stun, having a dispel, having Stampeding Roar, having Combat Rest, and a list of other things. When it comes to Mythic Plus, their utility is insane. Their legendaries, since I mentioned Priest having weak ones, are very good. They are very varied. The Double Life Bloom legendary is very strong. Circle of Life and Death, if you want to go full DPS meme, is also very good. Out of the Elder Druid as well, specifically for Mythic Plus, and burst damage with your Heart of the Wild. Speaking about Heart of the Wild, reason why they now also have the strongest DPS in Mythic Plus of all healers by a landslide. It is so strong that we got to the point where it is not hard or uncommon to see a Resto Druid top the meters in a boss in Mythic Plus right now because of Heart of the Wild. You essentially turn legit into a balanced druid for 45 seconds. This is way overtuned right now. Resto Druid is doing way too much damage. Resto Druid also doesn't have that many problems with spread healing. They only lose a fluorescence, essentially, and the rest is just all pots that they can easily spread around the group, even if they are in Africa. They are also one of the specs that is very good at dealing with Prideful and the stacking dot damage. the stacking pulsating damage, because guess what? They put hots on targets. You group all up inside the fluorescence, you hot all of your group and you're gonna be fine. Also, on a side note, they're also very good. if this wasn't enough, because Druid as a healer, back they lack a way to deal with diseases, but they can deal with curses and poisons. The toughest, trickiest and more annoying debuffs in group content are going to be poison and curses, specifically poisons. And Druid can get rid of them, which is also very important when it comes to Mythic Plus. Their characterization essentially remains the same. They are going to be S tier, S plus. We're going to be putting a little asterisk next to their S. It's actually S plus when it comes to Mythic Plus. And when it comes to raids, they're going to go down in C tier. Right below the barrier that is going to prevent all healers without a DR to actually make it past. Holy Paladin right now is left trying to cope with the butchering of their Glimmer of Light build. Glimmer of Light build is now a talent and it has been rather weakened due to the massive loss of borrowed powers. I mentioned some tanks being weakened by the lack of borrowed powers, I mentioned some DPS packs being weakened, and now this is our first healer that is massively weakened by the lack of borrowed powers. Ineffable Truth gone, Vision of Perfection gone, 30-40% haste lost at max level in Shadowlands is going to mean much lower uptime on your Avenging Wrath. Much longer cooldowns on your abilities that you used to scale with haste, much lower availability of your Holy Shock coming back off cooldown. Your another big problem, your Holy Avenger has been turned into shit from BFA. So now you have only one real cooldown with your wings. Holy Paladin used to be able to split their cooldowns between wings and Holy Avenger, now not really in Shadowlands. And Seraphim is also not making up for it at all. They still remain as a spec, as a class, with very strong core. Their utility, their cooldowns, their defensives are still very good. Lay on Hands, your own bubble, your own defensive, Blessing of Freedom, Blessing of Sacrifice. You have your Aura Mastery, which is an amazing tool. But because of the loss of your secondary stats, the loss of your borrowed powers, you're just weak right now. Your throughput has dropped heavily. Now you are amongst the lowest specs when it comes to throughput. Consistent, high HPS. You are bailed out by Divine Toll Covenant ability. The fact that you are starving for Holy Shock generation and Glimmer of Light generation, and this Covenant can give you 5 Holy Shocks every minute, is extremely powerful because you're on such a wheelchair right now. Your legendaries don't help you as much. Shadowbreaker can be, especially later on in the expansion, a very strong raid legendary. 40 yards. Light of Dawn like the Azerite trait, except now you also gain 20% more healing, which can be very strong in your burst. Maraz Dying Breath can help you with one of the problems that have arise now in this Glimmer build, which is your single target spot healing damage. You know, this heavy chunks of single target healing to get people out of trouble quickly. When it comes to affixes for Mythic Plus, for example, when it comes to Pridefall, it's gonna be sketchy for Holy Paladin because they don't have very high consistent healing. They would have to use their burst, but more often than not, the entire window of damage of Prideful mob is going to last longer. When it comes to bursting, you don't have Mass Dispel, you have to deal with it. Again, you don't have many other ways other than using your cooldowns. When it comes to Grievous and the stacking damage, if you can't properly cap all the party after your first rotations of Glimmers and Light of Dawns and whatnot, and Grievous will start stacking down, you're going to have more trouble healing multiple targets to full while they're dropping low as a Holy Paladin. In general, overall, they are still very strong in their city windows, and with their strong cooldowns, they are in A tier when it comes to raids and B tier when it comes to Mythic Plus. A tier because of their Aura Mastery, and their strong cooldown windows are still there. And in Mythic Plus, B tier because their utility is still there, their damage is still there, their strong defensives for themselves and strong cooldowns for the party, and their tank are still there. They're just on a much lower level than they were in BFA later on. You know, S tier in everything, very powerful. Now it's a little bit weaker. On the bright side, after this depression manifest, they are the spec that scales the hardest with gear as a healer. So you can at least look forward to that. Now let's imagine a universe where there are no bugs, no glitches, and no broken interactions for Monk, so we can properly assess the spec. Unfortunately, even in that universe, the Mistweaver Monk damage still doesn't work. They have the lowest damage of all healers together with Holy Priest. Even when you try to enhance it with Fist Weaving talents and legendaries, it's just too shit and not worth. They do still have very good utility for Mythic Plus, particularly the Ring of Peace. Even their Paralysis and they're sweeping Aoistan. They are one of the specs that is better at spread healing. They don't suffer from people running to Africa like a shaman would. When it comes to Mythic Plus, their strength is that their Life Cocoon is an incredibly powerful single target cooldown, and Revival is still pretty useful in Mythic Plus compared to a raid, mostly because in raids there are going to be other healers' raid cooldowns that shit all over Revival, and because in Mythic Plus you can completely dispel Bursting with Revival. Their power, specifically in Mythic Plus, has been sort of revolutionized by the power of this legendary, Tear of Mourning. The first effect is already pretty decent enough, 15% more healing is not that bad, but 25% of the Enveloping Mist and Vivify healing applied to the targets with this buff is very powerful, because your Renewing Mist jumping on multiple targets, even if it jumps on a target for 1 second before jumping away, is still gonna apply the buff, and after you've applied the buff you can spread around your Enveloping Mist, which is a very strong hot, and heal all of them tagged by this effect. And it's gonna spread around, it's gonna compound on itself, especially with the newly reworked Chiji, which is going to shorten the cast time of your Enveloping Mist, is gonna be made even stronger. This is going to fix one of the issues that Mistweaver has and had for a long time, which is AoE healing, particularly Mythic Plus, 4, 5, 6 targets. They were too tied for too long to things like Renewing Mist to be able to AoE heal. And forget me for mentioning it, for uttering the name Essence Font, which is a garbage ability. And with this legendary alone, they are definitely made stronger, which is why they are in B tier when it comes to Mythic Plus and D tier when it comes to raids. When it comes to raids, the lack of strong cooldowns cannot justify them being in a raid slot compared to the Chad specs with damage reduction cooldowns. And the fact that their consistent throughput, particularly the AoE consistent throughput, is still lower than a Holy Priest or a Resto Druid. And when it comes to Mythic Plus, they improve because of their ability to heal 2, 3, 4 targets in a much better and consistent way, which wouldn't be as prized in a raid environment. Their very, very strong single target cooldown in Life Cocoon is going to be also very prized, and their utility is going to be very important. They can't really rise above B tier right now because of their lack of damage. They need more damage to be able to a more consistent pick in Mythic Plus. But beyond that, they are, I would say, slightly improved over BFA. Again, praying most of the bugs are gone. Lastly, we are closing with Shaman. In my previous assessment of healers, I mentioned that it was a toss-up whether or not you would have liked the way Shaman was being buffed. Shaman got buffed by basically doubling the spell power coefficient of most of their abilities, but didn't really get anything new. So the real question was, can a spec be fixed rather than giving them a new talent, a new legendary that can change the way it plays, or maybe giving them a new ability? But simply given harder hitting heals, because the problem of Shaman was lack of single target tools. No strong single target cooldown, no strong single target bailout panic ability, nothing. Now their healing wave and their healing surge heal for twice as much as single target abilities, but you still don't have, say, a 10 to 15 to 20 second strong single target ability that you can use to bail yourself out. You still have to just hard cast Healing Surge or Healing Wave if you want to single target. You still have to use Spirit Link Totem on a single target if you want to use it as a tank cooldown. The problem in Mythic Plus for Shaman is that this spec seems entirely tuned around AoE. From Cloudburst Totem to Earthenwall Totem to Healing Tide Totem to Spirit Link Totem, all of these things don't even have a target cap. You just heal everything, which is what makes it so strong in raids, but not as much in Mythic Plus. Mythic Plus, you want to have also ways to save your tank reliably. The new talent that they gave him, basically the only change, Surge of Earth, is a joke. They gave him another AoE talent. Earthen Harmony is their only tank legendary, tank defense, tank heal legendary, and it's terrible. Chains of Devastation to help them increase their DPS in Mythic Plus is also poor, since Chain Lightning doesn't hit 5 targets for Resto like it does for Elemental. Shaman also suffers, as opposed to many other specs, from not being stacked, both on their chain heal range as well as their healing range, as well as in some cases their Spirit Link and their Healing Tide. They just benefit more from being together. When it comes to affixes, they have an easier time in Grievous. They do have a pretty high throughput, sustained HPS, and a variety of group cooldowns to deal with a pulsating damage of Prideful. When it comes to Bursting, same thing. They can cycle around their cooldowns and they can do very, very well through bursting as well as Grievous, with their mastery healing more on lower HP targets and their single target healing being so thick now. Grievous has been made easier for Resto Shaman. Their utility, unlike the druid, is weaker. It's not as unique as a druid. They have a slow, they have a stun, they have a dispel, but those are also not that uncommon in other specs. They don't have anything completely different than other specs as a utility tool. Windrush Totem, I guess, it's a unique thing together with some Pinning Roar, as well as Earth Elemental as a emergency tank tool in Mythic Plus, but not much else. They do have Cursed Dispel, which is pretty good, particularly in Revendreth team dungeons, like Sanguine Depths and Halls of Atonement, but they do lack Poison Dispel, which is very dangerous to not have Poison Dispel in several dungeons for Mythic Plus. When we consider all of this, together with the fact that their damage is lacking, yes, they have been buffed in most of their damage, but they lost Ignorous Potential trait, and they still have to stop nearly all their healing to do damage, which was their original problem in BFA. They are in C tier for Mythic Plus and S tier for raids. C tier Mythic Plus because they lack reliable ways to protect their tank, and their single target, although very strong, is still tied to just hard casting their basic abilities. They don't have any extra thing. Their utility is varied but not that crucial and unique compared to other specs. And the S tier for raids, well, the gigantic variety of AoE cooldowns is enough to guarantee them an S spot in a raid. Particularly Spirit Link, obviously, because of the damage reduction and the health redistribution. And there you have it. We have all of our healers neatly lined up into ratings for Mythic Plus and raids. I wonder which one of you expected to be higher or lower in this list. I think most people agreed around the trio for raiding. The damage reduction trio is going to be high up there just because of that, and the S tier of Druid in Mythic Plus, I guess, was a thing most people already knew. I think the biggest debate is going to be about where to place Mistweaver Monk, where to place Holy Paladin and Resto Shaman in Mythic Plus. I think they have potential to move around. I think between C and A they can sort of move here and there. Paladin mostly because of scaling, Mistweaver because of some of the interaction among its abilities and the synergy with the legendary, and Resto Shaman because, again, their abilities have been giga buffed and it might just be enough, although I'm not sure. So tell me what you guys think. Any of the specs let you down? Were you hoping for more? Have you been surprised? And in the meantime, I'm going to pray for Holy Priest.